So the next type of literal here is the string literal. And what exactly is a string literal? As I think you already know, you already have an idea what is a string. So strings are generally represented in inverted commas. Okay. So when I say any sequence of characters which are within double inverted commas, then is treated as a string literal. For example, if I say string S is equal to double inverted commas hello, so this hello is actually a string. So if I say string Q is equal to, this is a string literal slash N, so as you can clearly see here that string literals can also contain these escape characters. So I'm using slash N here, I'm using slash N here. So escape characters are also allowed in the string literals. And secondly, we are using this plus here for concatenation. So you can create a string like this which is having escape characters as well as which is also having concatenation. So if you are going to print this Q, so it is going to print in three lines, that is, this is a string literal. In the next line I am going to print which spans in the next line I am going to print three lines. Okay. If I say string H is equal to hello, now this is going to return an error. Why? Because it is going to consider this hello as a variable because it is not in the inverted commas. So if this hello is in inverted commas, then only it is going to consider this as a string. But if it is not in the inverted commas, then it is going to consider it as a variable. Now let me take a simple example. Let us say I create a character variable. So character A is equal to single quotes A. Now single quotes A means it is a character. But if I try to say character B is equal to double quotes A. Now because I'm using a double quotation here, double quotation means this is representing a string. And the string cannot be assigned to a character because obviously the string spans, it contains a lot of methods as well as string is, you can say string is a combination of character, then we are going to have a null symbol. But all as at the same time, strings are also immutable in Java. So we are going to see in the later part of time when I'm going to discuss more about strings, there will be an entire chapter based on it. So we are going to discuss more about strings. So right now we are just saying that to a string variable, what is the kind of values that you can assign. In the same way, we have seen to an integer variable, what is the kind of variables values we can assign. To a floating point variable, what is the kind of values that we can assign. So string literal means we are just trying to see what are the possible correct possible set of values and what are the incorrect possible set of values. Okay. So this was about the string literals. Now in the next video, let me give a brief idea, or you can say let me just discuss in detail instead of taking just a brief idea, let me just discuss in detail about arrays in Java programming language. Okay. And thank you for watching.